Journey to the center of a flowery heaven where the moon is hidden by the off-white snowbanks. People gather where their foes are friendly, cooks or Andy's, all the dimwits, lordies, and crookshanks. And out of candlesticks and paper we construct our temple to the honor of the Odyssey, the captain's apprentice. He defeated all the Easters in heroic fashion. Now he's simply called Syd the Weevil. He didn't get the praise enough, for his father was so tough on him. He thought his brother was a brighter one. His brother Patrick held him to a gun. Assassin Patrick. Patrick ran up to the castle and in his contriteness made a plea to absolve him from evil. The crowd rejected his defense. They went right over the castle fence. Went after Patrick in the highest keep. And Patrick cried out in his defeat. He tried to make his case, but they burned him at the stake.
These are the times that try Weevil's souls, and in that moment Syd knew that he had fucked up. Never was there a worse day in the memory of the Weevils.
In the memory of the Weevils.
In the memory of the Weevils. In their eyes was a fire that would not go out. It would not go out, but it would be cultivated and continue to burn for the rest of their sorry days.
As the crowd of weevils came down from their frenzy of vengeance, they still felt the sadness losing Syd, the captain's apprentice. They commissioned for his funeral the best musicians and the biggest tomb of the forest. All the weevils mourned him, the great stridulator, as his skeleton was laid out on the center of the table. The spirit of the town was often scattered and broken. All the sadness rose out in cold.